lost, rejected, abandoned. Every year, more than 100,000 dogs are found on the streets. They're picked up by dog wardens, taken to council kennels. But for many, the day they arrive at the pound is the day they join death row.
It's still between 8,000 and 10,000 dogs, at least, every year that we're putting to sleep, through no fault of their own, just because the owners don't come forward for those dogs or don't want them anymore.
At some council pounds, when a dog's booked in, the clock starts ticking. If they're microchipped, they stand a better chance of being reunited with their owners. But if they're not chipped, if they're not wanted, after 7 days in the pound, they'll be put down.
On a Monday, routinely at one day a week, they go around with a list of the latest dates. It doesn't matter whether the dog's a young puppy or an old dog or a beautiful pedigree Dalmatian that somebody's paid hundreds of pounds for. They'll just take the list of 20 dogs, those 20 dogs go to the vets and come back in orange bags in a wheelbarrow.
Chris Whippy has worked in dog rescue for 6 years. When he saw for himself how many were put to sleep, Chris wanted to stop the destruction. So he started volunteering for one of the few charities in the country that saves death row dogs.
The charity's called Doris Banham Dog Rescue. It was set up by the founder of the charity after her mother, who was an absolute dedicated animal lover. And when she died in 2001, her daughter decided to set up the charity in her name.
Today, Chris is loading up 9 dogs, 9 very lucky dogs. He's taking them to a holding kennel and rescue centre in Nottinghamshire, where they'll have the chance to find a new home.
Very small charity. We really do live on a shoestring and survive on a shoestring. We're too small to be able to afford our own kennel, so how we operate, we remove the dogs from the pound in 2 tattered-out old vans that travel up and down the country, finding spaces in other animal rescues. You know, it's a living, breathing creature, so that's why I'm in it, and that's why we do what we do, our charity. To hopefully, we're never going to prevent it, but at least we can make a difference, you know.
This is one of the holding kennels that the charity uses in Nottinghamshire. Dogs stay here until they can be moved on.
When Chris turns up with the van, it's just really another heartbreaking situation.
Oh, he can't go in a kennel, can he?
On board, one of the dogs was a really tiny little female Yorkie. Again, no history. Don't know why she was in the pound. Nipper, handed in, 12 years old, unwanted. Can't see any reason why anyone would want to get rid of a lovely collie like him. This is Philip. Philip is a little Steffi, who, as you can see, is absolutely adorable, very affectionate, just loves to sit with you and give you kisses.
But not all dogs are as friendly as Philip. Large and powerful breeds in the wrong hands or left in the wrong place can lead to disaster.
I got outside the yard of 8 when I was on the floor. I was shouting, "Will somebody please help, you know?"
Frank Tempest from Lincoln had his nose and ear ripped off by 2 pit bulls. That attack led to the introduction of the Dangerous Dog Act in 1991, and more recently in 2006, 2 Rottweiler guard dogs savaged and killed a 5-month-old baby girl in Leicester.
It's just a tragedy for everybody. Everybody, you know, all of a sudden there's like a panic about dogs again. It's like everyone's going to be very wary now when they see especially a Rottweiler.
These extreme dog attacks are very rare, but because certain breeds have had such bad press, rescue centres are at bursting point. On the road again, and Chris's next stop is at the halfway home kennels in Nottinghamshire. Over the last year, Valerie Hosegood has taken in more than 100 Rottweilers, many like Charlie, saved from death row.
He's a bit of a barrel, aren't you, mate?
It's a nightmare, to be honest. It's just got very, very difficult. I mean, we've been asked to take in 4 Rotties this week from pounds, ranging from 10 months old. It's getting ridiculous, really. As we're not a Rottweiler rescue, we're an all-breed rescue, but because I love this breed and feel sorry for them, I keep helping them. But, I mean, we've got long-termers that have been here over a year. And it just gets very difficult homing them because they've got to go to the right homes where they're going to stay forever.
Staffordshire Bull Terriers are another breed that's overpopulating the pounds.
Unfortunately, Staffordshire Bull Terriers are still the biggest percentage of dogs that come into stray pounds because of such a huge overpopulation of them. They're absolutely loving dogs, but they tend to be dog aggressive, and they do have a bad press. And unfortunately, it's not the case. Most of them are absolutely lovely, but still, 18-year-old lad living in a council estate wants a dog for a status symbol. It's a Staffordshire Bull Terrier he gets. Once he's had it for 3 or 4 months and it's chewed his carpet or it's not looking, you know, street cred or fashion's changed, then the dog ends up on the street in a pound, and thousands of Staffordshire Bull Terriers are put to sleep every year because of the overpopulation of them.
Now some councils are clamping down on problem pets. Nottingham City Council wants to limit the number of dogs and cats that can be kept by their tenants to 2 per household.
I've been a council tenant for 37 years. I've always had my dogs. I'm a trainer.
Janet has 4 German Shepherds. Her dogs are her life and she refuses to be parted from them.
No one will ever walk through my door and take my dogs. No one. Whatever it takes, I will do. I will move. I would do anything to save my dogs from being taken from me and put on death row.
Thanks to the work of charities such as Doris Banham Rescue, 90% of stray dogs are saved from death row. The volunteers go to huge trouble to find new homes for the dogs. Sometimes they even end up providing that new home themselves. Remember Nipper, the old collie dog? Well, he wasn't left in the kennel long.
The particular reason that I fell for this beautiful boy is because I'd just recently lost my own German Shepherd, and as he came in he had such a fantastic personality that I just fell in love with him, and he did with me and my little girl, and I just couldn't bear the thought of him of parting from him. So he's part of our family now, and even though he's part of our family I shall still carry on helping all the other dogs because they desperately need our help, and if it wasn't for us there'd be a hell of a lot of dogs that are getting destroyed daily.
And Sarah, the little Yorkie we met earlier, was snapped up by a terrier lover from Lincoln.
I think it should always be a consideration to take in an animal that needs rescuing and has got so much to give for what you give to the animal. I mean, in such a short time, she's given me so much.
I've helped 78 dogs and I will continue to do so while I'm still alive. Because if you get beautiful dogs like this, which is an encouragement to people to go out there and not buy a dog out of the paper, go and rescue a rescue dog and give it a bit of love and you'll get a lot of love back.